Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Lost in Time. Well, we're standing at the elevator, at the entrance of the to the elevator, and it's closed. But maybe a click on the portrait will help us, yes, to call it and go in. And now let's solve this riddle and see what we can do about that large can which is sitting on high under the roof. Okay, a button which we press. Let's do this first. Okay, let's take the notes. And we had red, that's for the colors down here. Red, the bullet, yes. Then we have red for the dagger, which is here. And we have yellow for, yeah, that's called, okay, the gun. I can open it now. It contains the ship's log of Philibert, captain of the Briscard. The one who died at the age of 28, yeah. Okay. And there is a piece of fiberglass between the pages. Hey, that's neat. Let's have a look at this notebook of this. No, we had that. Oh, there is the log. Okay. The Manor Lighthouse is inside. It is a moonless light. Night, I'm sorry. The weather is fair to partly cloudy with a cool breeze. I land at the crew and say hello. Now I am here alone. After all the years of conquest, the Briscard will ride her last wave. Perhaps I will leave with her. Oh man, and I mean, we're all telling this to the guy in the whatever closet right now. I hope we won't be on the ship when it crashes against the 17th of the Devil or whatever that name was. Oh my goodness. Okay, so now we know that. And we'll have to find a way to get to the bottles. And to get to this bottle maybe, or this can rather. But since we are carrying this big barrel and our sexy yellow outfit, we can use it on the bottles. And I don't know how about you, but I'm thirsty, so I will just, use cork on the opening. Let's uncork the bottle of cider. It's good. Yeah, Doralise, you deserve that. But now, that's what I did in my German Let's Play, but not intentionally, just because I had forgotten how to do it right. So she had some cider, which I think she deserved. But, yeah. Okay, I have to use the barrel again. Because she took it with her already. She stuffed it in her wherever, I won't say. Okay, and now we can use not the entire bottle of cider, but just the cork on, hello, on this can, and yeah, wow, she is really good. He's better than Freddy Farkas, a genius. It's so powerful that the cork flew out through the opening. Good aim, really. And what did we get in reward? A rust remover. Well, we are carrying a lot of stuff. Roasting spit, a razor, a copper wire, page remover, our pack of cigarettes with matchbox and no matches, the barrel and ore, the fire extinguisher, the kerosene, and some rust remover, and a rag, and resin, and a pipe, and fiberglass, I just read beer glass, no way, the wooden shoe, a glass shard, and a leaky hose. All right, I do know that we need the cork, so we'll have to do some MacGyvering here now. Yeah, you watch this and be surprised. The cork from my bottle of cider isn't there. Yeah, and we need that, so let's put the leaky hose to the water faucet. Okay. The hose is torn. Yeah, let's go and repair it. Because we found... How did fiberglass get into this logbook of 1840, we wonder, but we shouldn't doubt things in adventure games. We use it on a tear, on a leak, and then, of course, we can use our resin on the fiberglass. Watch out for the edges, and watch out for your wonderful red fingernails, yeah. So that's it. Now we can take the end of the hose and put it in the well. That's still long enough. Well, it was long enough to go from the lighthouse to the vault. And now let's see if the water runs. Everything's okay. Yes, because I pulled that wheel down below the lighthouse, remember? It's full. Great. Okay, we'll leave the hose here. And we can take the cork. Yeah, all that effort for a simple cork. But we had to do it. And so, now what to do next? Maybe we can take a look at the shipwreck. Let's go. So we go back to the basement right here. But the steel gate is locked. And maybe we can scratch the stuff off. The rock is too bumpy and the razor won't work well. What else do we have? Maybe the glass shard. I can barely cut them. We should soft them before. Okay. So what do we have? That wouldn't help much. Maybe the rust remover? Nope. Maybe the paint remover. Yes, that seemed to help. That was strong enough. And now we need something to scrub. Well, let's take the glass shard again. Yeah. And there is a mechanism. Not a button, not a lever, just a hole. But we do have our roasting spit. And put it in there. It goes well, but I can't get anything to move. Probably rusted. Well, how convenient that we just chop some rust remover down. And if we use that... Yay! Good. Okay, let's have a look at the boat. And if in some scenes this game reminds you of We in the Prophecy, which I also let's play, you're right, because it's from the same developer as Coktel Vision, and they also made Ween. It can't be used. It's full of water. I would need to get the water out to assess the damage. Yeah, right. But we do have a wooden shoe, which helps us on the seawater. Okay. And this is much easier than it was in Ween the Prophecy, where you had to repair a boat as well, which was annoying as hell, because you were already going on a boat ride in the open sea, and if you weren't fast enough, your boat was sinking, and you drowned and were dead. But here we just simply use the rag on the leak. And that's fine. And then, of course, that's why we needed this cork back. We use the cork on the leak as well. And we need nothing else, and that's it. Now, isn't that fantastic? It seems to be holding. I think it's more or less waterproof. Well, let's hope for it, so let's take a little boat ride. It won't be easy to go ahead with that, but it's better than nothing. Yeah, Dora, go on. I better leave all these heavy and cumbersome objects next to the barrel. Let's go. Okay, we should not forget to pick them up later on when we're back from our little ride on the ocean. Yeah. Ah, she's a real tough girl. I like her. Yeah, she does a lot of stuff in high heels, too, if you noticed. Not only a yellow outfit. I'm doing pretty well. I'm moving along, yeah, but be careful. She's also wearing yellow high heels. Isn't that sexy? I'm getting closer to the shipwreck. I can see it now. Yeah, we can see you going straight to it. It's actually a big ship. I should go around it. Yeah, Dove. Well, be careful, Dora. Be very, very careful. Oh, no. What's happening? The boat is going towards the rocks. Oh, I'm going to crash. Oh. Oh, bah, she's going. Now, come on. Don't. Whoops. Oh, man. Are we dead? Woman overboard, help! No use yelling, no one will hear you, sweetheart. The shore seems closer this way. I won't go back that way, the way I came. Too bad it isn't closer. Okay, now we landed somewhere. What a scare. I never thought I'd make it. I'm wet, but safe and sound. Well, I will not comment on this, no way. And there is a fisherman's house. And there are some cliffs. I could try to climb, but with bare hands, it's clearly impossible. And beside that, you would ruin your fingernails. There is a roof, and there is Bjoy, which we can't get. Not yet. So I hope Guybrush isn't waiting for us in here. Let's go and give it a try. Now, this time there are no locks to break. Oh, aren't we lucky, because we still have the small stuff. Oh, maybe we could have broken the door with something, or just with our hands, or with a wooden shoe, but okay, we didn't have to. So let's start to explore this nice little room, which is just this one room, and we can't go to the right or to the, well, we can go back or down. Just in here, so let's check this dresser. And, okay. What do we have? A ship in a bottle, nice job, and it's done entirely with matches. Hey, that's just what we needed. We just have to find a way to break this bottle. But we'll do that later, and we'll check the dresser again. So, what's that? Soy sauce? The local fisherman likes fish. Oh, is that, this fish sauce, yeah. Japanese, whatever, or Vietnamese, I never know. And there is a sweater, let's take it. Because our clothes got all wet. Actually, no, she doesn't take it. Instead, she got a handkerchief. And anything else in there? A nail. Okay, that's where... No, that's not where we got the nail. We got another one on the ship. And I'm sorry, what else? Ah, a piece of fresh bread. Baguette. Because we're in France, it must be baguette. And is there anything else, or can we take the sweater and wear it? No use, it doesn't fit well. Is it too big? Then it doesn't really matter. All right, so she doesn't want it. We can't open the drawer of this table. Okay, but there is something underneath the chair, which I would like to see. A notebook that is used to steady the legs. It belongs to someone named Melchior. I guess that's the one we're talking to right now and telling all the story on the big ship. Where should that be? Here. Jarlath Equus. Jarlath? Jarlath? We heard that name before. Yeah. He was born May 11 in 2059. Way in the future. And he's an historian. He has green eyes and implants, capillaries, and a new kidney. Well, that's better than some stuff some women get done, but okay. And distinctive features are: sleeps only 4 hours a day, is allergic to orchids, which is important to know, drinks hard liquor, okay, and practices hypnosis. He's dangerous, and we hope to never meet this guy. And besides, he looks like a psycho. Yeah. All right. And up here is a lamp. Primitive, but it works. Yeah, so I guess this is a hint that we should get the lamp. And since we can't access it from the ground, maybe if we move the chair, we can. Yeah. Climb up the chair, and there we get the handle, and since we found a nail, it's very easy to get that loose and get the whole thing. Let's have a look at... Oops! What's the chandelier made of? An anchor, cork floats, and a few candles. Great! Yeah, now we have floats. We have a candle. We do have matches in this bottle, but haha. Maybe we can break it open with the anchor. That would be easy. No, it doesn't do anything. I wonder why not. It would be logical. But okay. So that's all we can do here, and now let's move out and get back to our manor. So we have to get this. And of course, since I played the game, I know I have to put the fish sauce on the bread and throw the bread on the roof. And along comes Jonathan Livingston Seagull. Yay! Now, wasn't that a tricky one? There's rope, which we probably can't cut off. Yes, we can. All right. Okay, and can we take it? No, we can't. All right, then let's tie the rope, of course, to the anchor, which makes perfect sense. And use a hook on the cliff. And there we are, back at our house. And what's up next, and what we'll do in there, you can see in the next video. So join me for the next episode, and stay tuned. Bye-bye.